Hello for Wednesday, December 12th, and in the market on Tuesday, another good day. Look at this, Dow up 0.6%, that's $78. Closed off its high, but when it hit its high, you'd expect some resistance there because it ran up to the post-election high. You know, we ran up to 13,290 and then had this big pullback after the election. We're back up there. We've retraced 100%. The high of the day was 13,300. At the moment, it's probably getting a little extended because look at how many days up here. We've got five straight days up in a row. Volume was increasing. That's another bullish sign, but we are running up the top Bollinger Bands. Maybe it needs to go sideways a bit. If it breaks some, if it does go further, look at this next dotted line we have right up there. That was after that first day pullback, and then we consolidated. That's some resistance as well. But of course, everyone's looking right here. You can see a left shoulder, right shoulder ahead. So inverse head and shoulders, and that measures, what, about 800 points up here. So that would clearly put us above the, that'd go up to 14,000 area from, if this is the neckline at 13.3, then we've got 14,000, what is that, 14,100, and that puts us above the 13.6. Of course, so there's a possibility we come up here and then a breakout as well. At the moment, if we can go sideways, consolidate a little bit, kind of match this whole thing over here, maybe go up and down a bit, holding this 50% retrace level. We may drop under the 61.8, which is at 13,207, but we can hold in this area like just happened over here, maybe a mirror of that, and then we go up for maybe an end of year rally. Anyway, that's it's an idea, and it could work out that way. Here we've got the S&P 500, similar deal. Made it up to the, let's see, 1434 was where it was before the high of the day was 1434.27. Look at this, 1434.27 here, 1434.27 to the penny, and it was increased volume as well. That's quite bullish. So once again, we could break out here. We're not at the top Bollinger Band, but to go sideways first would be much better. To just the same kind of deal. We like to consolidate in here a little bit more and then break out for that end of year. We got the Russell. We're not so happy with this because of the gaps here, because now we've got this one sort of filled. This one didn't need to be, but then we got another one. And that happens quite often when you have this situation where you have it resistance at 830.55. So what do? You just gap to it. I mean, you know, it's hard to break through it, so you don't. You gap through it. Actually, the open was 12 cents or 15, 17 cents below there, but so close. It's just a couple of trades and it moved it on up, so closed up 1%. We said in the newsletter this is the time of year for small caps. Quite often mid-December is when the small caps start really moving, and you can see it up 1%. Meanwhile, the SPX is up 0.65% and the Dow is up 0.6%, so it moved up twice that of the percentage of the Dow or the SPX. So good job for the small caps. If we look at some of the futures, you can see here what transpired as well. From this little pullback here on the 25th to this level at 1396, and then since we are right there in the morning, we posted this showing that from this distance right here, we had a short-term Fibonacci projection up to the 127, be 1431. We did a little better than that, but basically closed right under it. So if we can close back over 1431, then the next level would be the 1441, another 10 points higher. That's the six. That's both. The reason you can't read it, it's both the 161.8 projection from this level. It's also the 78.6 Fibonacci retracement on its way back up to the 1468 high. So both of those are very valid, which means if we get there, expect even more resistance, and then eventually a breakout of that could really take off, because when you have these overlapping Fibonacci levels, quite often that can happen. Here's the Dow, was kind of hanging right around this top trend line. It's a wedge, so it technically could be bearish, but if it starts moving sideways, then all of a sudden this gets negated. We do have RSI, this 240 minute chart, over 70 again. It's up at 71, almost 72 points. But we've got our 78.6 level up here at 13,349. So if we continue up higher here, expect some resistance there. If we back off now that we've got this trend line here, the one that's coming down from up here, that was a 10.17 was the last touch October 17th. So if we come down, if we can hold that in the top of this line somewhere in that area, that would be just great. That'd be very bullish. So watch that, because if that held, that could be a trade point as well to buy in there. We talked about the euro and yesterday and about how it's looking a little more bullish because it held this support area here, which is the former 38.2. And it bounced up, and now it's back inside the triangle. If it were in the next couple of days, this is a daily chart, so the next couple of days, it's not out yet up to the apex of this triangle. So if it can continue to move up, it'd be fine to break out right about this level as well. Now, it doesn't mean it's going to, but it'd be a good setup if it does happen. We'll mention natural gas as well. It continued a little bit lower. And you can see it yesterday we talked about it was at the 127, and that's based from this move up here, this leg. So as it dropped, we had a 127, and then we have the 61.8, which is at 335, and that other line that's right there, it's a little bit above the 61.8. That was that recent low, which was down in the August 19th, basically, in that area. So, okay, that's what we're watching anyway on natural gas. So next up, we have just pointing out that the dollar, you know, had run into resistance here at the 50-day EMA and the 20-day moving average. And note this, the 20-day moving average is 80.67 exactly at the 50-day moving average. So if this drops some more, the 20-day is going under the 50-day. And that, of course, is bearish for the dollar and okay for the euro. Generally, it used to be that way, and nowadays it's a little hard to tell. Anyway, we've got gold kind of consolidation day. I'm a little bit lower volume, didn't do much, it was flat. So therefore, GDX didn't change much either. It was down 24 cents. We're short on that, and of course, still long on silver SLV, and it was down 23 cents as well. Okay, let's take a look at some of the additions, or some of the stocks, what they happened from the watch list, and then we've got some additions to the watch list as well. First off, we've got Conquer Technology, CNQR, which did indeed trigger, and it moved up pretty nicely. It was up $2.38, closing off its high, but not far off its high anyway. It was a decent setup anyway to begin with. We liked the one, and because it had a big move up, we wish we'd caught it, this bullish flag that it had, but still, we got a good move on it up. A couple points there, DYAX. Also pretty decent. It gapped a little bit over. Came right back down there to pick you up if you wanted. If you'd missed it before, you know, it was 333 is where you wanted. That's exactly where the low was. Perfect, perfect, perfect. And look at this volume. Super volume. Normally it's under 500,000 shares. It did 1.6 million, so three times normal volume. And that was a very nice trade. WCG triggered also running up to the first area. We said this $50 area is fine. And we look up toward the 51.75 area where we have the next line, but we knew that there's going to be some resistance to the 50-day EMA. That's at 50.57, and the high of the day was 50, 57 points under. So I think it's going to move some more. Maybe it'll run into resistance. If not, then expect it finally to get up to there, but it was okay. It moved up about 73 cents on the close. That's where it was. GTIG, I don't know why I'm having it here. I was looking at the chart. I didn't trigger yet, but one to watch is still in that consolidation area. LPS, I think we're not counting it because we're up here at the within about 10 cents of that, and that way you'll see it. It needs increased volume. A 25.44 is a 50-day, but it did start moving above. It was up a little bit, 37 cents, or about 1.5% is all. But it has closed over the 200-day EMA, and that's the first time since back here in late October. And Life continued. This is just second day, just showing, though, it did hit our target, and it could run further from here, but that was our immediate target. It was just this $1.50 move from the 50 area up into the 51.50 area. WCG also triggered, went up to its same, just like the couple charts ago, goes up to the 50-day moving average. So a small move at the moment. If it can break over to there, that also could get up towards the 52 area. And MENT, which actually triggered on Friday, pulled back a little bit, and then again on Monday, and it gapped up. It's still not really rocking, but it did trigger, and it moved up higher. Okay, here's some additions to the watch list. Not bad. This is very similar to one we just talked about, but ARRY, another biotech. you can see just above this little breakout line that we're showing at 397, because that was a recent high. Maybe you prefer four, or you prefer to wait until it clears all of this. But it did hold the 20-day when it moved down here. So it moves up above this area. We've got some 200-day at 403 and the 50-day at 411. It's got to clear both those. But if you're in it down here, you know, maybe you'd like to, if it's got good volume, I think maybe it can boost above. If it does close above those, it's going to get a lot of notice. Do note the Williams just started to come above 80. It's at 79.11. Not a lot so far, but if it does continue with good volume, then it's going to get some notice, and then this gap will be filled, and maybe it can continue up. And the RSI did close over 50, which is kind of bullish to get it back up at that area. BKD was up 4.5 points. So it may need to rest a little bit, not move right away. But in the past, you can see over here, look at this, over a course of 4 or 5 days, it did good from $21.89 to $25. Over here, it did the same after a gap up $22.50. In a couple days, it's already up to $25. So maybe, since this was the first day move, this would can continue as well. And for that, over about $25.83, we're interested. CLSN. $8.40, $8.35, let's say, and then it was $8.39 on Wednesday. But look at the volume. Once again, these big volume moves, lower volume in the consolidation. You know, everyone didn't just run in and say, well, good, now we're at the top and we'll sit. They're thinking it's going higher. And you get enough people, if they've all bought, then it's not going higher. But if other people think, you know, they're into something, let's get into it too, then we get a breakout above that 840 area. CY. Didn't we just talk about them recently? I can't remember. Cypress Semi. It is getting over the top Bollinger Band, but it had increase in volume as well. Other indicators are looking okay. $11 or 11. 13 was this high over here in October. But I think the $11 might be okay. And see how it goes to start. Eventually, the first target would be up at 1225. But it may have problems because it's going to get overbought over this top Bollinger Band and have to pull back. We'll see how the market goes too. If we get a year-end rally, some of those may continue to do quite nicely. RBCN, Rubicon Technologies. Maybe you want to trade it within this range because this increase in volume is kind of impressive. We'll officially say 722. That's where this is the high of this day. So one day it, you know, gapped a little bit and then sold off all day and came back up the next day. That's the opening price is 722. Maybe you want a little higher, like 725. That was the close of the other day. But somewhere in that area or a little bit lower, if you, that would be the normal trade. But if it can hold this 5 or the 664, maybe you can get it in there with a stop underneath. Otherwise, on the break above, we point it to you, point it out to you. You do how you, depending on your trading style, how you like it. REGN, another pharma. In kind of a pennant, we draw it that way to show you it's more like a pennant. So the exact price would be how you do it. If you like to draw it by the close of this candle and the open of this candle, then we're basically very close to breakout. If you like to draw it a little looser, I'd say you want to get back over the 189. Here it was 190, the 189.95. I think 189 is fine if it has volume, because then the chances of it going up another buck are really high. And if that does that buck and doesn't break out, you can say, well, take a buck. And but if not, then we have a new run possible on our hands. So that's what we have for this Wednesday. Hope you have a good trading day. Thanks a lot for watching. We'll send tweets out before the market opens and during the market day as things develop as well. And otherwise, we'll be back in tomorrow with some new ideas in Market Wrap. So have yourself a great day. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.